creatures praise Christ, the giver of life, who has risen from the dead and has crushed the doors of death with his might, putting even Hades itself to death and destroying its spearheads of death. He also saved Adam and Eve. Let us cry to him with the voice of thanksgiving, with continuous praises to him who has risen from the dead on the third day, for he is the all-powerful Lord and Master.
Thank you.
the grace of the Holy Spirit may come upon them. Let us pray to the Lord. For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, and want, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by thy grace.
Thank you.
by your mind, and your neighbor as yourself. And he said to him, you have answered rightly, do this and you shall live. But he desired to justify himself, said to Jesus, and who is my neighbor? Jesus replied, a man was going down from Jerusalem to Jericho, and he fell amongst robbers, who stripped him and beat him, and departed, leaving him half dead. Now by chance a priest was going down that road, and when he saw him pass by on the other side, so likewise a Levite, when he came to the place and saw him, passed by on the other side. But a Samaritan, as he journeyed, came to where he was, and when he saw him, he had compassion and went to him and bound up his wounds, pouring on oil and wine. Then he set him on his own beast and brought him to an inn and took care of him. And the next day he took out 2 denarii and gave them to the innkeeper, saying, take care of him, and whatsoever more you spend, I will repay to you when I come back. Which of these 3 do you think proved neighbor to the man who fell among the robbers? He said, the one who showed him mercy. And Jesus said to him, go and do likewise.
Lord, have mercy.
For you are mercy.
loving the Lord has corrected me, and have now surrendered me to death. The Lord is my strength and my praise. In such having me, the Lord has corrected me, and have now surrendered me to death.
His God.
The reading is from the Epistle of St. Paul to the Romans.
Let us be attentive.
Strong enough to bear with the failings of the weak and not to please ourselves. Let each of us please his neighbor for his good, to edify him. For Christ did not please himself, but as it is written, the reproaches of those who reproach you fell on me. For whatever was written in the former days was written for our instruction, that by steadfastness, by the encouragement of the scriptures, we might have hope. May the God of steadfastness and encouragement grant you to live in such harmony with one another, in accord with Jesus Christ, that together you may with one voice glorify the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Welcome one another, therefore, as Christ has welcomed you, for the glory of God. For I tell you that Christ became a servant to the circumcised to show God's truthfulness, in order to confirm the promise given to the patriarchs.
Peace given to you unto the reader in wisdom. Let us be attentive. Jesus said to him, today salvation. because of your love towards mankind. Forgive them whatever wrong they may have committed, whether by word or deed or thought. Purify them of every sin. Preserve the remainder of their lives abiding in your commandments, and in them may your most holy name be glorified. For you are the God who shows mercy and saves us, and to you do we ascribe glory. With your eternal Father and your all holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us be attentive. Peace be unto all. Wisdom be attentive. Silver nor copper in your belt. bodies, and for the putting away of every infirmity and disease, and every malady, and defilement of both body and spirit. Send down, O Lord, from heaven, your healing power. Be the physicians of these your servants, granting to them through your holy church complete restoration of health, so that they all shall do and act and be in accordance with your will and with what is pleasing to your holy majesty. For it is you who show mercy and save us, O our God, and unto thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us be attentive. Peace be unto all. Wisdom be attentive.
Hear me quickly, O Lord, on the day that I call upon you. The reading is from the second epistle of St. Paul to the Corinthians.
Let us be attentive.
Brethren, what agreement has the temple of God with idols? For we are the temple of the living God. As God said, I will live in them and move among them. I will be their God, and they shall be my people. Therefore, come out from them and be separate of them, says the Lord, and touch nothing unclean. Then I will welcome you, and I will be a father to you, and you shall be my sons and daughters, says the Lord Almighty. Since we have these promises, beloved, let us clean ourselves from every defilement of body and spirit, and make holiness perfect in the fear of God.
Peace be with you, the reader. In wisdom, let us be attentive.
Alleluia.
Alleluia. Wisdom, let us be attentive as we listen to the Holy Gospel. Peace be unto all.
And with your spirit.
The reading of the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. And when Jesus entered Peter's house, he saw his mother-in-law lying sick with a fever. He touched her hand, and the fever left her, and she arose and served him. That evening they brought to him many who were possessed with demons, and he cast out the spirits with a word, and healed all who were sick. This was to fulfill what was spoken by the prophet Isaiah. He took our infirmities. his disciples followed him.
Glory to you, glory to you.
Let us pray to the Lord, who loves mankind, exceedingly merciful God of all comfort, who through your holy apostles have granted us the power to heal the infirmities of your people with oil and prayer. To you confirm this oil for the healing of those who shall be anointed with it, for the relief of every ailment and from every malady, and unto deliverance from every evil. Yes, O Lord our God, it is you whom we beseech, O Almighty One, to save us and to sanctify us all. Heal your servants and protect them with the mercies of your goodness, and visit them with your kindness. For if we are favored with your inexpressible love for mankind, may we praise and glorify you, who performs glorious deeds, both great and miraculous. For it is you who shows mercy and saves us, O our God, and to you do we ascribe glory, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. To all, wisdom be attentive.
You shall keep us and protect us from this generation, forever.
And your God, for righteous are becoming you. Lord, you shall keep us and protect us from this generation, forever.
wise took flasks of oil with their lamps. As the bridegroom was delayed, they all slumbered and slept. But at midnight there was a cry, "Behold, the bridegroom, come out to meet him." Then all those maidens rose and trimmed their lamps, and the foolish said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out." But the wise replied, "Perhaps there be none to be, there not be enough for us and for you. Go rather to the dealers and buy for yourselves." And while they went to buy, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went in with him to the marriage feast.